Hi, good evening.
Hi guys, good evening. Thank you for joining. Hello, hello, hello guys. How are you?
Hi teacher.
Hi guys, good evening. Thank you so much for joining. ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo están? How are you doing?
Fine.
Everything good?
Yes.
Okay, okay, nice. I'm glad to hear that.
Hello.
Second, hello.
Hello, hello.
No. Okay, guys, so welcome to class number.
Good evening.
Number 11. Hello, good evening. Hello, hello, I got 19. I'm missing some. Okay, everybody, so thank you so much for joining today's class. I'm super happy to see you today. And, you know, one more hour that we are spending. Today we are going to like practice a lot. So I hope you're ready for it. So may you then please with your cameras, as we always do. Let's get started with the attendance. Okay. And me ayudan con un present para, you know, compliance purposes. Guys, ahora que si todos tienen la cámara, oh, les voy a tomar la foto. I'm going to take a picture. Bye. Sonrisa, please, everybody.
I can
keep it. I have no problem. Me falta Walter. I'm missing Walter. Okay, now I see you. Okay, guys. So let me take a picture of you all. Hold on. Okay, let me count. Ophelia is joining. Wait. Emma. I want to see you, Emma. Pues sí, que salgan todos. Vaya, guys. Give me a smile. Say cheese. 1, 2, 3. Ahí está. Okay. Ya se la voy a compartir. So, thanks everybody, and please, si ayúdenme con la cámara, let me go over the attendance for today. So, give me 1 second. There we go. So, I got Astrid Lizette. Creo que ya había Astrid por ahí. Thank you so much. Carlos Felipe.
Present.
Thank you, Carlos. Daniela Alejandra.
Present.
Thank you. Dinora. Perdón, Carolina Lisette.
Present.
Thank you. Dinora Estela. Diome Sistito.
Present.
Thank you. Okay. Edwin de Jesús.
Present.
Thank you. Emily Yamilet.
Present.
Thank you. Emma Tatiana.
Present.
Thank you. Guadalupe Herrera. Italo Vladimir.
Present.
Thank you. Jennifer Sarai.
Present.
Thank you. Jerry.
Present.
Thank you. Eliseo. José Ramón.
Present.
Thank you. Karen Lorena. Crisia.
Present.
Thank you. Lorena Stephanie.
Present.
Lorena.
Present.
Lorena Stephanie, right? You say present.
Sí, present.
Thank you. Media de la Flor. Miriam Esmeralda.
Present.
Thank you. Ofelia.
Present.
Thank you. Okay, de Jesús. Rafael Armando. Roxana Maribel. Rocío, Silvia Rocío. Susy, thank you. Susy, Stephanie.
Present.
Thank you. Tania, Tania Karina.
Present.
Thank you. Present. And Walter.
Mateo,
present.
Thank you. ¿Cuál es Carla. Su nombre, Miss?
Carla María.
Carla María Ceciliana.
Sí.
Coming. Thank you. ¿Me falta alguien más? Am I missing anybody? No. Okay. Okay, guys. So, thank you
Hola.
So much.
Acabo de conectarme. Creo que, perdón, ya me había mencionado quizá.
Okay. Sí, creo que sí, pero ahorita la marco, no se preocupe. Gracias. Ana Maribel.
Sí. Gracias.
No problem. Okay, everybody. So let's get started today. Today vamos a cubrir dos temas que son like very important. El primero es sobre seasons, okay, a little bit of clothing. Y el segundo es descripción de actividades que estamos haciendo ahorita. Like, what are you doing right now? Normally we say we are in classes, pero a veces también estamos viendo la Rosa de Guadalupe, you know. Estamos oyendo like what our neighbors are doing and everything. So we are going to talk about those activities in a couple of seconds. But before, I want to get started and I want to show you one video that is related to some seasons, okay? When we are talking about seasons, in El Salvador, solo tenemos dos. We have only two seasons. One is winter and the other is summer. So it is cold or hot, and that's it. We don't have like a lot of different seasons. What is your favorite season? ¿Qué prefieren? ¿Invierno o verano? What do you prefer? Winter or summer?
Winter.
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 Okay. Winter. Wow. Okay. I mean, yes, I definitely prefer winter too, because I think it's cold. So, I mean, es como un poco gray, es como un poco sad, but I think it's better, right? So the objective of today is to become familiar with the weather season. Even though no tenemos todas las estaciones, es un poquito de cultura, right? So we are going to get familiar with some seasons around the world, okay? So you can also tell me. ¿Hay algún país donde le gustaría ir? Is there any country where you would like to go? ¿Donde hayan visto que están todas las cuatro seasons?
Yes.
Where would you like to go?
Germany.
Okay, Germany. Any other country, guys?
Alaska.
Okay, Alaska. I would like to go to Japan. And I think it's, you know, I have never seen the four seasons together. Y si me gustaría ver como las cuatro estaciones y el cambio de estación. That would be super awesome. Now let's take a look at this. For example, when it is winter in El Salvador, solo llueve, right? No cae nieve. But in some countries, es bien helado. It's very cold. There is a snow, right? Y tiene que usar mucha más ropa, right? So, what are some of the things that we can wear? ¿Qué usaría si nevara, if there is a snow in El Salvador? ¿Qué usarían, guys? What would you wear?
A boat.
Abrigo.
Okay. Sweater, boots, gloves, guantes.
Wear a raincoat.
A raincoat, okay. You would have an umbrella, yes. Right? Mm-hmm. Gloves, yes. A scarf, okay. So let's take a look at the following video, okay? And let's get familiar with some vocabulary. Let me mute my...
Hi everyone. In this class, you'll become familiar with the weather seasons, and you'll also listen to a conversation which illustrates how this topic is used. Let's start by listening and repeating.
It's spring in Brazil.
It's warm. It's very sunny.
It's summer in Korea.
It's raining. It's hot and humid.
It's fall in the US.
It's cool. It's cloudy and windy.
It's winter in Russia.
It's snowing. It's very cold.
Now, let's listen to the conversation. It's Hi, everyone. In this class, you'll become familiar with the weather seasons, and you'll also listen to a conversation which illustrates how this topic is used. Let's start by listening and repeating.
It's spring in Brazil.
It's warm. It's very sunny.
It's summer in Korea.
It's raining. It's hot and humid.
It's fall in the US.
It's cool. It's cloudy and windy.
Okay, everybody. So let's take a look at the description that we have for the different seasons. For example, here we have, it's a spring and it's warm. It's very sunny, okay? So it's very sunny. Está como muy soleado, right? Here we have, it's raining. So, like, if you take a look, hay umbrellas. Entonces, en este momento está lloviendo there. So it's raining. It's hot and humid, all right? So está como raro el clima, kind of weird. It's fall in the US. So fall or autumn, so it's cold, it's cloudy and windy. I love October because it's cloudy and windy. Then we have here winter in Russia. It is snowing and it's very cold. So what type of weather do you prefer? Do you prefer sunny days? Do you prefer cloudy and windy days? Or hot and humid days? Or cold days? What do you prefer?
Cold days.
Snowing.
Cold days?
Very cold.
Very cold. Cloudy and windy.
Cloudy and windy? Okay. Cloudy and windy, cold. Okay, sunny? What about sunny? You can go to the beach. When it is sunny, it's mejor ir a la playa, right? Do you like sunny days? Not really. It's too hot. Okay, so that's totally fine. Now, let's take a look at the following conversation. Okay, give me 1 second. Let me mute.
It's snowing. It's very cold.
Now, let's listen to the conversation. It's very cold, which illustrates how this topic is used.
Oh no.
What's the matter?
It's snowing and it's very cold.
Are you wearing your gloves?
No, they're at home.
Well, you're wearing your coat.
But my coat isn't warm and I'm not wearing boots.
Okay, let's take a taxi.
Thanks, Julie.
What I would like for you to do next is to practice repeating the conversation that we just heard. This conversation will make a lot of sense for our next topic.
Very cold.
Now, let's very cold.
Okay, so let's take a look at this conversation. The person is saying, it's snowing and it's very cold. Imagine, our country no es tan helado. It's not freezing, right? It's como cool, but not that cold. Now, let's take a look at Julie's question. Guys, are you wearing gloves? ¿Alguien anda gloves right now? ¿Alguien anda guantes? Are you wearing gloves? No. Are you wearing a sweater? Is anybody wearing a sweater?
Me.
Jennifer, okay, Jennifer is. Only Jennifer? Anybody else? Are you wearing a sweater?
No.
Are you wearing a hat? Como un gorrito? Are you wearing a hat? No? Not really. What about glasses? Are you wearing glasses? Is anybody wearing glasses? Oh, Edwin is, it has a hat. Okay. Yeah, I see that. All right. So what about glasses? Are you wearing glasses? I see Silvia with glasses. Yeah. I think I saw, who else wear glasses? Edwin, do you wear glasses? No, right? No, you don't wear glasses. Carlos, do you wear glasses? Are you wearing glasses?
Yes.
Oh, okay, okay. Who else wear glasses? Jose Ramon? I think I saw Ramon with glasses. Nobody else? Miriam, do you wear glasses? No puedo ver bien, but I think you wear glasses, right? I think I see her with glasses. So let's take a look at it. We are asking about this very moment. Sobre lo que anda puesto. And the question is, are you wearing your gloves? Are you wearing glasses? Okay. You're wearing your coat. Anda como un abrigo, right? You're wearing your coat. So, but the person says, I'm not wearing boots. She is wearing, ¿cómo se llaman tacones altos? How do you say tacón? ¿O zapato alto?
High heels shoes.
Thank you. She is wearing high heels. Okay. She is not wearing boots or something comfortable. Okay. Now, this brings us to the following. First, I need please two volunteers who can help me read the conversation. So, who wants to volunteer? Volunteers. No volunteers.
Me.
Thank you. Okay, ¿quién dijo me?
Me, teacher.
Sorry, it's not showing. Okay, thank you, Roxana. Roxana, and I need one more person. Roxana, please, be so kind y escoja a la persona. Choose another person.
I don't know.
Puede ir a participantes. You can go to, oh, thank you, Emily. Thank you so much. So, Roxana, you can read Pat. And Emily, can you please read Julie?
Okay. Oh, no.
What's the matter?
It's snowing and it's very cool.
Are you wearing your gloves?
No, they are at home.
Well, you're wearing your coat.
But my coat isn't warm. And I'm not wearing boots.
Okay, let's take a taxi.
Thanks, Julie.
Nice. Thank you, girls. Very good pronunciation. Okay. Now, this one nos trae al siguiente tema. And it's describing activities, okay, that are happening at this very moment. Like, what are you wearing? Are you wearing gloves? Are you wearing glasses? Are you wearing a cap? Are you wearing a hat? So, let me stop presenting and let me go on para presentarles el segundo objetivo of today, okay, which is describing activities que están pasando ahorita. So, ¿qué es lo que estamos haciendo? What are you doing right now? One second. For example, from the cameras, okay, I see that Emma is drinking water, okay. I see, for example, that Susie is very focused. She is paying attention, you know. Okay. I see, for example, that Italo is smiling. So, está sonriendo, right? So, I can describe like different activities that we are doing, guys. And to get familiar with this topic, I want to present my screen. Give me one second. My internet decided to think a lot today. Okay, so in the meantime, mientras termina de cargar, let's do the following. Oh, there it is. Okay, no worries. So we are going to check this. By the end of the class, you will be able to form statements using present continuous. Some of you, tal vez, en clases anteriores, you know, in the university, school, high school, escucharon present continuous, present progressive. So, vamos a refrescar un poquito cómo utilizarlo, right? And then we are going to use it. We are going to practice this. So, let's take a look. Let me present this video. Let me mute myself so we can listen to this video. Yes, there we go.
Hi everyone. In this class, you'll learn how to form statements using the present continuous. Let me first give the definition of the present continuous. We use the present continuous whenever you want to talk about an action that is in progress in this particular moment, right now. For example, I'm talking right now. I'm explaining. You're listening to the class right now. Let me write a quick formula in order to understand how to form these statements. Subject plus verb to be plus the verb, plus ing, plus some kind of complement. As you can see on the chart, we will use the subject of the sentence plus the verb to be plus the verb in its ing form plus some complement in order to express sentences in the present progressive. On the examples, you can see the verb to be is contracted, and that's because when spoken, we typically use contractions. I'm illustrating the chart without the contractions to better understand the topic. So, as our examples show, you're wearing shoes. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and write that here. We have the subject, it's you, the verb to be, are the verb plus ing, wearing, plus the complement in this case happens to be shoes. We're wearing shoes. They're wearing shoes. When forming negative statements, you will just add not after the verb to be. Let me give an example on the chart. They are not wearing shoes. They are not wearing shoes. If we made the contraction, that'll be they're not wearing shoes. Finally, the conjunctions towards the right-hand side, and but, are used to give additional information or to contrast an expression. For example, it's snowing and it's very cold. That's giving additional information. I'm wearing a coat, but I'm not wearing boots. That's contrasting information. Now, I would like for you to give some examples of your own. Talk about the activities that you, your family, your friends, and co-workers are doing now. For example, I'm learning English. My wife is cooking dinner. My boss is working at his office. Give as many examples as you can and share them in our discussion forums.
Okay, everybody, so this is kind of present continuous, right? And it's, we are going to use these para describir de hecho lo que ahorita está pasando, okay? Whatever activity you see everybody doing right here, okay? So, one second. So, as you listened previously, we can follow this structure para poder ordenar nuestras ideas. Subject, be, luego el verbo, but this verb con ing, right? And then the complement. Complement. And that's it. So, let me make this a little bit bigger. Okay. So this is be. So this verb has or must have ing. Then we get the complement. And pretty much this is going to be your formula to make sentences. So what I want you to do right now is the following. Take a look at everybody's camera, please. And I want you to try to say whatever they are doing, all right? Si se están moviendo, si se están riendo, si están viendo. So, of course, pueden inventar un poquito. So you can make things up a little bit, all right? For example, I see Susie, and I can say, oh, Susie is, porque es necesario el verbo to be, right? So Susie is writing, I think, in a notebook. Creo, pero no estoy segura. So I would say Susie is writing in a notebook. Okay, or Susie is, for example, taking notes, okay? And this is pretty much verb to be. ¿Cómo le voy a agregar este ing? How can I add the ing? It's actually very easy. It's not that complicated. Let me give you some examples here. I get, for example, the word write, okay? I have take, I have smile, I have study. ¿Me ayuda con más verbos? Can you help me with more verbs? Any other verb that can see your mind? Read. Okay, so imagine for example, I get this, okay? So lo que vamos a hacer normalmente es solamente venir y agregarle ing. So read se convierte en reading.
Teacher, si está poniendo ejemplos, no estamos viendo la pantalla.
Ay, pensé que solo era yo. Y por eso me
really? Paré. No, espérame entonces. Give me one second.
Volvamos ahora al inicio de la clase.
No, wait. Ahora sí la ven.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Yes. Thank you for that. Yeah. Okay, yes. So let me go ahead with this. For example, I have the word read. Lo único que hago es agregarle el ing, right? Y eso es all. I have, for example, work. Pero solo vengo y le agrego ing. Y es un verbo. That's like an ing form. I have study. No le voy a quitar nada. Solo le voy a agregar ing. And that's it, right? I got smile. Pero con smile, la E no se pronuncia, entonces no la necesito. So, smiling. Acá tenemos una excepción o una like rule, let's say, de cómo usamos el ing. Cuando terminen con E, se la voy a quitar. I'm going to eliminate it because I don't need it. Again, take. Termina con I. I don't need it. So, taken. It becomes taken. I have write. Again, I don't need it. I'm going to use writing, ing, and there we go. Y así formamos las, así formamos la forma de ing. Are we okay?
Okay.
Now, hay un par de verbos que pueden ser un poquito diferentes, right? In, especially in the part of spelling. So let me go ahead and share this. Swim and cut, right? Swim, this one, and cut. Tienen algo en común. Son cortitos, ambos son bien cortos, right? Y tienen consonante, vocal, consonante. So, consonante, vocal y consonante. So, ¿qué cambia con ellos? Why are they different? Because with these verbs, I'm going to choose a different color here. Vamos a hacer algo diferente. First, cuando tienen consonante, vocal, consonante, voy a duplicar la última letra. I'm going to double the last letter. Y después siempre le agrego ing. So swimming, cut, va a ser lo mismo. Duplico, ing. And that is the change. So, son de los poquitos que le hacemos cambios, right? So, only that happens when you have consonant, vowel, consonant. Okay, everybody. So now, I'm going to give you like 2 or 3 minutes para que podamos escribir like some activities that ya sea el compañero, your classmate, some activities your classmate is doing, or pueden ser sus family members. So what are your family members doing? What is your baby doing? Okay, what is your mom doing? What is your sister doing? All right. So, o si no el vecino, you know, what is your neighbor doing? So, aunque no lo vean, we can definitely make some examples y podemos inventar un poquito. So, you can be a little bit creative. Any question with spelling? ¿Alguien tiene alguna pregunta?
Teacher.
Hello.
Solo a los verbos se les agrega el ing.
For example.
Play.
Yes, of course. Los verbos sí podemos definitivamente agregarles ing. So I have, for example, this one, play. Yeah, lo único que voy a hacer es agregarle ing. So no le quito nada. I'm not going to modify anything. Solamente le agrego. Las excepciones aplican con la E, right? Cuando tengamos un verbo al final con E. Por ejemplo, I got this bird, right? So that is dance. Lleva la E al final, no la necesito. So I eliminated and I have ing. So esas son como parte de las pocas excepciones that we get.
Digamos, con la de play, o sea, juego. Uh-huh. Y coloco el ing como para hacerlo, que lo está haciendo como la acción. ¿O no?
What do you mean? I don't think I get your question. I mean, yeah. Cuando usamos ing, la combinación de el be con el ing describe actividades que están pasando ahorita. So, definitivamente, uh-huh, okay. Right now. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Hay más usos de la ing, yes, pero ahorita vamos a enfocarnos como en las actividades que están pasando right now, yes. Let me make this bigger. I think it's good. Okay, everybody, so I'll give you like 2 or 3 minutes and escribamos qué están haciendo sus familiares. What are your family members doing? O los compañeros. So pueden revisar las cameras there and try to guess what are they doing.
Teacher, una pregunta. Perdón.
Yes, please. No se preocupe, dígame.
Digamos, cenando. Dinner es cena.
Sí, pero el verbo cenar es la combinación. So you can say, I
sería
am
comiendo.
Correcto. I am eating dinner or I am having dinner.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, guys, I see your examples here. Juan Ramon is wearing a cap. My mom is drinking milk. My brother is reading a book. He is writing a history, a story, I would say. Carolina is listening to our English class. My brother is asleep in Kenya. My sister is playing. Okay, good, Ophelia. Solamente creo que se me comió por ahí el is. My sister is sleeping. My boyfriend is eating. Okay, eating, sin el am. My brother is watching TV. My sister is eating. Carlos is counting money. Silvia, ¿quién Carlos? You mean like Carlos Felipe?
Sí, Carlos Felipe.
Okay. My mom is washing dishes. O cambiamoslo por ahí. My mom is. They are. Okay. Dime si solo agregamosle el are. They are studying. My brother is working. My daughter is watching TV. My dad is listening to music. My husband is washing dishes. We are learning English. Edwin is writing the examples. My mom is dancing. Okay, nice. Sounds really good to me. Okay, guys. So, I'm going to give you some minutes because I want you to listen, okay? Quiero que también escuchen cómo se pronuncia and I want you to pay attention to your classmates. Y no se nos olvide, please, agregarle el verbo to be, right? I am, she is, we are. So, eso es una parte fundamental of what we are saying. So, vamos a irnos al grupo una vez. We are moving to the groups just one time. Listen to your classmates, listen to the examples, try to understand what they are saying, okay? Y si les falta algo, si se les olvida, por ejemplo, el verbo be, respetuosamente le podemos decir, se te olvidó el verbo be, right? Agregale el verbo be, so that's totally fine. So la idea es que siempre nos ayudemos de la forma más respetuosa posible. So everybody, let's go there. I will send you the invitations and you have only 5 minutes. 5 minutes.
F-A-L-L-I-N-G.
Sí, sí.
A sleep, dormir.
Sleep. Yes.
Yo qué.
Se está durmiendo.
No, no me estoy durmiendo.
Así tengo la cara, dice, dormida.
No, pero no.
Okay.
Ahora voy yo. Edma is writing at the computer. Is writing, está escribiendo, sorry, no pronuncio mal.
Writing.
Así es, sí, lo escribí bien, no, no sé.
Sí, así es.
No.
No es que yo dije, Emma está escribiendo.
Escribiendo. Ahorita voy.
Reading.
W-R-I-T-I-N-G.
So Jerry is falling asleep. Really, no, Jerry? Ya le vieron la cara de sueño. Podemos usar asleep junto. Ah, y luego asleep. Juntito, sin espacio. La primera, donde dice Jerry. Falling asleep. Sí, se está quedando dormido.
Ahí está
bien. Eso está bien. Lo último, donde dice A y luego sleep.
Sleep.
Correcto. Podemos usar Jerry is falling a A. La A estaba bien. La A is good. Solo A.
Así
es perfect. Yes, that's good. Asleep. Es como se está quedando dormido.
Y Emma está escribiendo.
Emma is writing.
Cooking a delicious dinner. I think.
Dinora.
My mom is thanking.
Thank you.
Como pensando.
Ajá. Thinking.
Es dormir, ¿verdad? Entonces diría yo, my cat sleeping. Is sleeping.
Sleeping.
Ajá. My cat is sleeping. Oh, ¿así sería o no? Sí, sí.
Ajá, yes.
Mi gato está durmiendo.
My cat is sleeping, sí.
Ajá, my cat is sleeping.
Okay. My neighbor is singing Juan Gabriel. My neighbor is singing Juan Gabriel. Mi vecina está cantando Juan Gabriel. Okay.
Okay. My father is watching television.
And you, Dinora?
My dad is shading.
Shading.
Cambiándose.
Shengen.
Así se pronuncia.
Okay.
Shengen, algo así. Cambiándose. Shengen. Shengen.
Okay.
¿Quién más?
My dog.
My mom was talking.
uno por uno.
Walter.
My dog is angry. Como, no sé cómo pronunciarlo con ING.
Te quiero decir.
Mi perro.
Eso sería angry. Solamente my dog is kind of aggressive. Pero no le podríamos poner ING porque no es una actividad. Lo que sí le podemos poner es escucho al perrito que está ladrando. Esa sí es una actividad. Eso sí yo lo puedo decir como mi perrito está ladrando. My dog is barking, porque eso sí es como una acción, right? Angry no se puede porque no es un verbo, no es una acción como tal.
My dog is barking.
And barking es como el
ladrido.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. My teacher is supervising the class.
Yes. monitoring.
Monitoring. Yes.
Class. Supervising is super good.
Supervision.
Yeah, but no, I'm monitoring. So
monitoring.
Ayuda,
okay.
You know? Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yes. Just correct. My teacher is correcting the class.
Oh my God! You got a lot of examples. I like it. That's nice. Nice. I like it. Otra.
Okay. Otra, Dinora o Jennifer.
My cats are playing.
Your cats, kids?
My cat.
Su gato.
Jugando.
Ajá, sí. Ajá.
Playing.
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 Ajá.
Your cat are playing.
Your cats are playing.
My cat okay. is playing.
My cat, your cat.
Sí, my cat. Ajá. Perdón, sorry. My cat. Yes.
Ajá. Is
playing.
Playing. Y el the complement
sería are. No, verbo to be no. are.
Okay. Subject, my cat.
V-A-L-L.
Gracias. También puedo decir, my friend is cooking a pizza. Mi amiga cocina
pizza. My friends sería como are, porque utilizamos friends como plural. Mis amigos están, ¿cuál era el verbo?
Cooking.
Cooking. Cocinando pizza.
Ajá.
Sí, sería como cooking pizza, cocinando pizza. Ajá. Lo único que vamos a usar es el are antes del cooking, porque estamos hablando de sus amigos.
Quedaría my friends are cooking pizza.
Are cooking pizza. Uh-huh.
Pizza.
¿Sí? Sí, creo que ya hicimos varios ejemplos. Gracias. ¿Y quién hizo los ejemplos de ayer? Sobre el...
Un back return.
Hey, thank you for returning. We are going to wait for the rest because not everybody is back.
Regresamos.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we are.
To return.
We are back.
Return.
Okay, guys, so I was like checking some of your groups and I'm really happy with the results. So I'm super proud of you guys. Very good use of present continuous. I didn't listen to like big difficulties that you were having. So really good. That was very, very nice. I also see that some of you shared that in the group. So that's nice. They are really good practices. So, so guys, what are your classmates doing? I like one example. I was listening to, I think it was Jerry. So you took Jerry as an example. ¿Qué se hizo Jerry? I don't see him. And so you were saying like he was falling asleep, I think. Se estaba durmiendo, right? So they saw Jerry's face like, you know, ya cabeceando and everything. And they say like, oh, Jerry is falling asleep. Okay. But that was a very good example and very good vocabulary. Porque aprendemos más vocabulario that way. So that's very nice. Okay, guys, any other sentence que fue como interesting for you? ¿O que aprendieron cómo decirlo en inglés?
En nuestro grupo aprendimos cómo decir entristeciendo, porque no sabíamos cómo si decir triste, sadding pensábamos. Entonces ahí investigamos y vimos que se decía como saddening. No sé si así se pronuncia, pero la escritura sí la aprendimos.
Sí, pero no. sí se puede saddening, pero no como no como una actividad, sino como un sentimiento, you know? Que un sentimiento es entristecedor, let's say. Pero podemos usar feeling, de sentir. Me siento triste. Me estoy sintiendo. I am feeling sad. I am feeling mad. So, podemos usar feel para situaciones de ese tipo. Sí. Uh-huh. I am feeling. Uh-huh. Yes. Edwin, creo que tenía una pregunta por ahí. Y la respuesta es sí. Your spelling is correct. Uh-huh. Otra, guys. Any other example?
Por ejemplo, laugh es como ríe, pero como riendo o sonriendo es laughing.
Son diferentes. Si es de sonrisa, sería smile. Yeah, like smile. Pero si es de sonreír, de ja, 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 that's laughing. Uh-huh. So, I am laughing. She is laughing. So, laugh, exactly.
Es como decir que se está carcajeando.
Yes, yes, exactly. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, el verbo es laugh. Aquí, de carcajearse, no solo smile, you know, sino el sonido así that we make. Mm-hmm. Ramón is laughing. Let me see. No, I don't think he's laughing. I see him smiling. Uh-huh. I don't know. Yeah, but I wouldn't say. I saw Silvia, and Silvia was laughing. So Silvia was like having fun there. Okay. Any other word that we learn? Any other activity? Es porque no le escucha Silvia. Okay. That's interesting. Tania, what about you, girl? Any word, any new sentence you get? Any interesting thing? Tania? Dinora? Girls?
Swimming.
Okay, de nadar, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. Very nice. That's okay. So, I have a little activity for you. Carlos is sleeping. Hay una expresión que nos puede ayudar bastante. Sorry, Jerry, pero me gustó su ejemplo, so I'm gonna use it. Okay, so.
Dancing.
Okay, hay esta que dice Carlos is sleeping, right? Pero si yo digo que alguien está durmiendo, es porque ya está como en la cama tirado y ya pasó a mejor, you know, al sueño de Morfeo. So that's, this person is sleeping, okay? And we have this other part. Que ya estoy cansada.
Yo creí que ya pasó a mejor vida.
No, a los brazos de Morfeo. So, yeah. And then, you know, puedo estar como bien cansado, ya cabeceando en everything, pero no estoy dormida, right? Entonces puedo usar la segunda, que es Jerry is falling asleep. Se está quedando dormida, right? So, nobody is sleeping in my house right now. But si alguien está dormido, oh, this person is sleeping. Pero si se está quedando dormida, que ya le ven como, you know, doing something like this. So, it's falling asleep, right? Okay. We have 4 minutes. Necesito un voluntario. I need one brave, courageous volunteer. Can I have a volunteer?
My family is dancing.
Oh, really? Is your family dancing? Yes. Right now.
Wow.
Can we look?
It's party.
I want to see that now. Okay. Guys, necesito un voluntario. I need a volunteer. Girl or a boy. Anybody. No es para nada malo. So. I got no volunteers. Okay. Yes, Silvia. Excellent. Okay. Silvia. Un segundo.
Glasses.
Ramón también dice.
Quiero
participar.
Deme un segundo. Silvia.
New glasses, Silvia.
Silvia Rocío. Guys, vamos a hacer lo siguiente. Le voy a enviar una oración. I'm going to send you one sentence. And everybody, quiero que veamos a Silvia's camera. porque nos va a hacer como la mímica de qué es lo que está pasando in these sentences, all right? So. Okay, there we go, there we go. Oh, sorry. Se me fue. El spelling está wrong. Pero ahí está. Do you see the sentence? ¿Logro ver la oración? Yes, okay, nice. So everybody, let's look at Silvia and intentemos adivinar, try to guess what she is doing o qué está intentando decirnos, right? Any idea?
Is so, jumping.
Jumping.
¿Estás saltando y comiendo right. como conejo?
Okay, close, close, close.
Pijama. Yeah,
he's jumping.
Jumping. Okay, wait.
Wait.
She left. She said, wait. She said, wait.
Silvia
is eating.
Un conejo.
Conejo, rabbit.
So what is the sentence? What
is eating carrot.
It is a rabbit.
Oh,
eating
rabbit.
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 Actually, yeah. No, but yes.
Eating carrot.
Yes, excellent. That was my rabbit is eating, but you got carrot. That was excellent, Silvia. Awesome. I like it. And you got some carrots. That was so nice.
Silvia is a little rabbit.
That was very nice. Okay. Okay, guys. One last volunteer. Can I have one last person? Really, really quick. Ramon, would you like to give it a try?
Okay.
Awesome. Okay. So, Ramon. Ya lo vi. Okay. So, everybody, let's look at Ramon. I think it's easy, but... Okay.
Cooking.
Is
Ramon
watching,
is eating.
Watching TV.
Yes, watching the movie. Carlos, you got Excellent. It. Awesome. Carlos got it. That is, I am watching TV. Excellent. Exactly. That's it. Okay, everybody. So that is present continuous. We use it para hablar de lo que ahorita está pasando, what's going on right now. That was a very nice participation of everybody. Y antes de irnos, solamente let me go ahead and check the attendance para que nadie se me quede like out of the attendance. Give me one second. Let me just take a look here. Okay, so let me call out your names and let me just make sure that you are here. I got Dinora. Dinora, creo que había Dinora. I think
present.
Yes, I knew present. It. Thank you. Diomesis. No lo había marcado, Diomesis. I got Jose Eliseo. Are you here, Jose?
Present.
Yes.
Present.
Thank you. Awesome.
Estamos.
Miria de la Flor. Miria. No, right? Okeli. It's not here. Rafael.
Present. Estamos.
¿Y me dijo present? Oh, Diomesis. Okay.
Sí, yes, ya habíamos Thank iniciado. You. Sí, yes. Yes. Yes.
Creo que se me quedó por acá o se me fue. Un error de dedo. Rafael, no, right? I don't see Rafael. Okay, everybody. So thank you so much for your participation. That was nice. That was super good. I will be seeing you tomorrow. And please, intentemos avanzar con la sección número 4. All right? So bye, everybody. Have a good night. Enjoy it. You see you. Bye. Sleep well.
Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night.
Goodbye.